This week, our developer advocates will get you up to speed with all important developer news.
Eventing in Kima allows you to easily integrate external applications. Under the hood, Eventing implements NATs to ensure that Kima is able to receive business events from external sources and is able to trigger business flows using functions or services. And NATs is a great technology for that. Still, now with the commercial offering of the Kima runtime available on SAP BTP, many of you have asked if it's possible to use the SAP Event Mesh for messaging, as it's the native event hub for business events. And I'm glad to tell you that this switch is now available. Once you turned on the SAP Event Mesh, nothing stops you from starting awesome Kubernetes projects that react to events from your SAP systems or any other application on SAP BTP. Visit the SAP Help page we linked in the description box to find out more information about this new messaging option and instructions how to make the switch today.
The latest blog post in the series looking at SAP Graph is out now. This post looks at SAP Graph's data protocol, which is OData, and uses the sandbox powered by SAP API Business Hub to explore the data model and the relationships between namespaces, entity types, and more. There's also a current series on the Hands-On SAP Dev show looking at SAP Graph, and you can use this handy playlist to catch up with the latest episodes. Also, if you're looking for more background and learning content on OData, we recommend this tutorial, Learn About OData Fundamentals, which is available on the Tutorial Navigator.
With the acquisition of AppGyver, a great low-code, no-code platform joined SAP, you can simply put together smaller apps over the provided AppGyver Composer Pro tool. And the best part of all of this is AppGyver is free for life for all indie developers, organizations, and nonprofits with less than $10 million in revenue or funding.
In this news item, we want to highlight the Open Source Way podcast, which is a series covering open source trends, topics, and projects, and is part of the Open SAP podcasting series. If you look at the kinds of podcasts in this series, you will find many topics of interest to developers. Past episodes have highlighted SAP open source projects and contributions to open source projects, but also general open source topics and how open source is impacting internal SAP development as well. The most recent episode caught our interest because it covers the Rust programming language. This episode that looks at Rust in general, but also you get to hear from SAP internal developers working on lower level development. Both participants in this podcast are involved in spreading knowledge about Rust in general at SAP. Regardless of if you are just interested in learning about more about the Rust programming language or hearing how some of the lower level programming languages and tools are used within SAP, this is a podcast that you want to give a listen.
Hey folks, my name is Julia and I am an SAP community advocate for the customer experience topic. But what does that mean? So I'm helping this and many other communities to best position themselves on the SAP community platform. And today I'm going to show you how to find even more information around the topic. But before we get started, let me tell you something about customer experience itself and ask you one question. How can you turn satisfied customers into loyal customers and loyal customers into enthusiastic ambassadors of the product or the brand? Exactly, through sophisticated and successful customer experience management. This enables us to generate an emotional bond between the user and the product or the provider. If you find this topic as interesting as I do, There is plenty of content on the SAP Community topic page for customer experience to read more. There you will find recent event information, product updates, new product launches, everything that your heart will desire. Go to Ask a Question, and there you will find all of the questions that have been raised around the topic recently. And if you like to read even more, then go to blog posts, and there you have your whole lifetime to read through the content of customer experience. All you have to do is to follow the tag customer experience and get involved with the community there. And I will see you around.